Hi, my name is Son Nilsson, and in this video, we will talk about transform constraints. A transform constraint copies a bone's world rotation, translation, scale, and or shear to one or more other bones. This can be used to rig your skeletons in clever ways. The simplest is to animate a single bone and then have other bones also animate, but it can also be used to simulate reparenting a bone, for example, grabbing a hat and putting it on the head, drawing a weapon, or throwing an object. Interesting effects can be achieved by constraining only a subset of the transform, for example, only transforming rotation but not translation. A bone can also be positioned automatically at any percentage between two other bones and more. To use a transform constraint, you need at least two bones. The bone whose transform will be copied, and the bone or bones to be constrained. The constrained bones will then have their transform adjusted. To begin using transform constraints, select the bones you want constrained, then click New in the properties below the tree, choose Transform Constraint, and then choose an existing bone to be the target. You can also click in an empty space to create a new bone to be the target. Note that the target bone cannot be a descendant of the constrained bones. The mix sliders on the transform constraint controls how much the bones are affected by the constraint. When the mix is zero, the bone's own transform is used and the transform constraint will have no effect. When the mix is 100, the bone's transform is adjusted to match the target bone's transform. Setting the mix somewhere between 0 and 100 results in a transform between the bone's own transform and the target bone's transform. For example, if I want to position a bone between two other bones, I can set the mix value to 50%, and now the bone will be positioned between its parent and the constraining bone. When link sliders is checked, all the mix sliders will have the same value. The value of the offset sliders are added to the target bone's transform values. For example, a rotate offset of 90 degrees would add 90 degrees to the target bone rotation when the transform constraint is applied. Without the offset sliders, an additional bone would be required for offsetting. The match button configures the offset sliders to match the transform of the first constraint bone. Instead of adjusting each slider manually, it is often easier to first set the mix slider to 0 and then use the standard tools to manipulate the transform of the constrained bone and then click match to set the sliders to that offset. For example, if I wanted to constrain a bone to the tip of another bone and not the root, I will first set the mix sliders to 0, then move the bone to the tip and then click match. Now when I set the mix values back to 100, the constrained bone stays at the tip. Changing any of the mix sliders in animate mode causes the key icon next to the transform constraint to turn orange. Clicking the key icon sets a key for the mixes, which are always keyed together. Keying the mix can be used to enable or disable the transform constraint during animations. So, this covers transform constraints, and I hope you found the video useful. Bye for now.